It's one fine morning in New Hampshire, and you're sitting on the dewy grass of a lakeside, enjoying the serene oak forest view after a short hike. In the sky, you notice dozens of double-crested cormorants flying south. One of the birds even manages to drop a baby crab right on top of your nose. The crab and all the organisms that are involved in your dramatic morning are part of a greater biological organization that forms life. Do you know what they are? Let's start from the tiniest scale of biological organization, the subatomic and atomic level. Every element on Earth is made up of atoms, each consisting of three subatomic parts: proton, neutron, and electron. These subatomic particles allow us to distinguish between elements. For example, there is one more proton in nitrogen than in carbon, as well as more neutrons and electrons. Living beings primarily consist of the elements nitrogen, carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen, which bond together to form a structure called molecules. Now, among these elements, carbon is essential in molecular structure due to its ability to form long chain or ring structures. Smaller molecules serve as the building blocks for the macromolecules like carbohydrates, proteins, and fats. Now, if we take a close look at protein, it's composed of amino acids and has important roles within the body, including accelerating reactions, transporting nutrients, acting as a chemical messenger, and bolstering the immune system. It is also an important part of cell membranes, which envelops organelles and protoplasm. Several organelles, such as ribosomes and microtubules, are themselves proteins or have proteins. Organelles are the organs of a cell that keep the cell alive and well-functioning by generating energy or digesting cellular waste materials. The shape and characteristics of a cell indicate its specialized functions. For example, nerve cells have long thin extensions called axons, enabling a rapid transmission of impulses. Meanwhile, muscle cells have densely packed filaments called myofibrils that allow flexible body movement. The great need for energy is accommodated by abundant mitochondria in the cell. The muscle cells in different parts of the body are specialized even further. For example, the muscle cells surrounding the heart, or cardiomyocytes, are short, branched, and interconnected cells that maintain the heart contractility. Groups of cardiomyocytes from cardiac muscle tissue. A tissue is a group of similar cells that performs one function. Several tissues work together and form an organ. In the heart organ, for example, cardiac muscle tissues and connective tissues give the heart its ability to pump blood and keep its structural integrity. The lungs, brain, and intestines are among a few of the organs found in our body. Further out, organs with closely related functions make up one organ system, such as the digestive system, which includes the mouth, esophagus, stomach, intestines, and anus. Several organ systems are organized and form an individual. An earthworm, a red oak tree, and a moose are on an individual level. However, a flock of them or an area filled with red oak trees are on a population level. A population is a group of the same species that inhabits an area at the same time. Now, how about the whole forest? The forest is a community, where there are some different populations that live closely and interact in a region. For instance, a red oak-dominated forest may have populations of gray squirrel, black birch, and mycorrhizal fungi. As they interact with non-living environments, they form an ecosystem. Some ecosystems in greater regions make a biome, where it has a distinct climate. There are five major types of biomes that make up the entire inhabited part on Earth, or biosphere. Tundra, one of the biomes, is a significant carbon sink, storing one-third of total carbon from the atmosphere. But the rising temperatures over the years that have thawed tundra could potentially release more of the stored carbon emission back into the atmosphere. This will add new threats to life on each level, and it is our concern as humans to restore the stability of nature for future generations. Thank you for your continuous support, especially our valued patrons and members who have been encouraging us to keep producing more quality content.